Gloria Nawanyaga got to know that she was born with HIV at age 11. Her mother disclosed it to her.
I kept on asking her, why am I taking drugs? By that time I was on septrin. Why am I taking drugs? Why am I going to hospital for checkups and all that? So at a certain point she felt like she needed to tell me, because at all the time she had refused to tell me, because maybe I was still young, but then she realized that as I'm growing up I'll still get to know one day. So she took me out and she asked me, what do you know about HIV? And I told her what I know about HIV is. Everyone who has HIV is going to die.
The thought that went through Nawanyaga's mind was that having HIV meant a person was due to die.
Of course, that was what we were taught in school, that if you have HIV, you're going to die. And posters were everywhere in school, everywhere, that HIV kills. So definitely if someone has HIV, they're going to die because HIV kills.
She recalls the anger she had towards her mother for a long time, blaming her for having to live with HIV.
I hated myself. I hated my mom, I hated everyone at home. I didn't have hope. I thought I'm going to die. I thought there is no future for me.
Over the years, Nawanyaga has had frequent medical checkups and adheres to the drugs. She, however, recalls that it was only one time that she developed AIDS. It was due to stigma.
In 2009, I got AIDS, which is the combination of all those diseases that are caused by the virus, which is HIV. So it happened so that, of course, rumors have to walk, have to move in the village. And people started talking, that girl there, omwala wawa ina stream, omwala wawa ina HIV you get. So when I went back to school, there was a neighbor of ours, a student. Yes, a student. So he saw me. I was entering the, it was called by that time a main hall. Yes, a main hall. So when I entered and then I put my head down because I was not feeling well, then he started saying, you're sitting at Ambula.
At the university, after rejecting a boy's love advances, she finally opened up about her status. She was stigmatized after people found out she was positive.
He came to me and told me, you know what, Gloria, I like you. I told him, are you stupid? I asked him, are you stupid? Are you crazy? I mean, your girlfriend is my roommate. She's my classmate. We're in the same class. We're in the same course. And we're doing everything together. And you want me to be, you know, dating you? It all looked crazy. So when I refused him, so Nina's full of song. He went in my suitcase when I was not around, because he had moved in, he had access to the keys, to the room, and checked for my medication. I think he had suspected, maybe, I don't know. So when he looked for my suitcase, he went and got my medicines and my medical forms. And immediately, him knowing that I have HIV, he went to his girlfriend and told the girlfriend that I was seducing him and I wanted to infect him with HIV so that he can infect the friend.
Even her friends abandoned her.
I ran away from campus and hostel for 2 good weeks. But where I ran from, I asked myself, well, how long will I keep on running away? Because this is my HIV status and it's not going to change.
We also asked Gloria about her love life after disclosing her status.
And yeah, we also have feelings. I've ever been in love. Yeah. And I've dated several guys, not many. No, I've never infected anyone in my life, and I don't wish to do so. And as I told you, for the past 8 years, I'm undetected. That means I cannot spread or infect anyone.
Nawanyaga advises young people to stay safe so they do not get infected, and for those living with the virus to religiously take their medication.
Well, you know, these campuses, I'd rather get HIV than getting pregnant. My dear, pregnancy is for 9 months. HIV for the rest of your life, you're going to be on medication. Do you know what it means? Some of you people have even given you coartam and you have never finished the dose. Yeah? And you're saying, I'd rather have HIV. And people, and some of them, when they see us looking good, they're like, Castor, you're looking good. The medication is there. The medication, you know what it means to take that medication, my dear?
Report by John Musenze for the news.